Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Subhashish Mishra and today's topic of discussion is on outlier or anomaly detection. Before we start, if you are new to my channel, please like, share, subscribe and turn on the notification bell so that you will be notified whenever any new video gets uploaded. So let's get started. What is an outlier? An outlier or anomaly is a value which is completely different from the rest of the data. For example, if you have an age column available in any kind of form that you are filling up. Okay, so if you make it blank, then as you already know, most of the age columns are by default having a drop down value called as 11-1900. That means at the 1900th year, 1st of January. So if you don't fill it up, then for you, the age will be like 121 years or 122 years as per as like that. Okay, so that is not the relevant scenario. So that is called as an outlier or an anomaly. So we need to deal with the outlier or anomaly whenever we receive any kind of data from any source. Okay, so there are various techniques of dealing with outlier detection. The famous one are Tukey method, in which we will be using the interquartile range for detecting the outlier and then removal, and then the JET statistic score, and then the box plot. Now let's check one by one. So here we are in the Jupyter notebook. Let's get started with importing the necessary libraries we want. Import NumPy as np, import pandas as pd, okay. Once we import these things, then the first thing first is the detection of the JET score. We will be seeing the JET score detection. So for JET score, now suppose we have a distribution of list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, let's say we have a list called as 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and so here the mean is 3. Okay, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 is 15 divided by 5, which is coming into us as 3, and the standard deviation is 1. Now we want to convert this distribution that we have right now into a normal distribution where the mean will be 0 and the standard deviation will be 1. As we already know, further standard deviation for the normal distribution, the mean is always 0 and the standard deviation is 1. So we can be able to do it by using the JET score. So the JET score formula for finding out to convert any kind of distribution into a normal distribution is x of I minus mean divided by the standard deviation. The x of I is the data points that we have over here. Okay, so this data point minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. So for this point, like 1, it will be like 1 minus 3 and then the standard deviation is 1, so it will be minus 2 divided by 1. So whatever the value it is like minus 2. Okay, so the JET score value for 1 is minus 2. Similarly, we can be able to calculate the JET score value for each and every data points. So once we do that, then based on that, we can be able to create the normal distribution. Alright, so let's go ahead and discuss everything else one by one by creating the data sets and then finding out the anomaly out of it. Okay, so let's say that we will be creating a variable named data, which consists of some random data, random variables. So we will be using np.random.randint. Let's say the number starts from 10, ends at 15, and the number of data points we want is 20. Once we do that, we can be able to check the data. It is an array of 20 points between 10 to 15. So to convert the data into an array, into a list, we can be able to use the data is equal to data dot to list. Once we do that, it will convert the data into a list. As you can see, now the array is being converted into a list. Now we will add some sort of values to create the anomaly. Okay, so for that we will be adding into the list data dot append. Let's say we will be appending 100, then data dot append 200, data dot append 300. Let's say we're adding these three data points, not 200, 300, it will be too much of skewed data. Again, we'll be discussing about what is the skewed data also, not in this video, but in going further, whenever we will be discussing about the bias variance trade off, then we will be discussing about the skew. All right. So we have appended three data points. Now let's check the data. Starts with 12, and here we can be able to see that 100, 120, 130 are the data points which are added. Now let's check the 2K method for the outlier detection. Okay, so the steps are, for this we will be arranging the data in increasing order, and then we will calculate the quartiles, the Q1 and Q3. So once we find out the Q1 and Q3, we will be then finding out the interquartile range. Once the interquartile range is there, then we definitely will be finding out the lower bound or the upper one, or we can be able to call them as floor and ceiling. Okay, so let's sort the data. We have a method called as sorted, and inside that if we put the data, then the data will be sorted. Let's check out. As you can see, it starts with 10, and then with an increasing order it moves into 130. All right, now let's find out the quartiles. The quartiles are Q1 and Q3. To find out the quartiles, we have something called as np dot percentile. And then data of, then for the percentile, if you will see the documentation, takes A and Q. A is the data, Q is the quartile points we want. Okay, so here the A is data, and for the Q, the quartile points we want is 25 and 75, which is the Q1 and Q3. Again, these are the things which we have already discussed in our measures of dispersion video. If you haven't checked that, I will encourage you to go ahead and check it out. I'll link it in the I button above and also in the description below. So once this is done, we can be able to see the Q1 is 11, Q3 is 14. Okay, now let's find out the IQR, interquartile range. So IQR is Q3 minus Q1, and then we will see what is the IQR. It's 3.0. Now let's find out the floor and ceiling, or the upper bound and lower bound. So we'll first find out the lower bound, which is Q1 minus 1.5 times the IQR. Okay, and the ceiling is, or the upper bound is Q3 plus again 1.5 times IQR. Now this 1.5 times that we are multiplying with the IQR, this is predefined. Okay, this is what is being the basic assumptions. We can be able to change this based on the business requirement or the business ideas that we are getting, We can also ask the business people that whether they want 1.5 or 3 or 4.5. Based on their requirement also, we can be able to change it out. But for by default, the multiplication point is 1.5. Okay, I have made a mistake. I just messed out Q3. Now, once this is done, we can be able to check out the floor and the ceiling. The floor is 6.5, ceiling is 18.5. Now, based on this, we will be clipping up everything else above 6.5, which is probably not there over here, and below 18.5. So, what are the below 18.5? The 100, 120, and 130. So, these three points will be our anomaly. Alright. So, let's discuss about the second method of this finding out the anomaly, which is called as the JETSCO method. So, for that, let's create something called as outliers list, blank list. Then, let's set up a threshold limit. In case of JETSCO, whenever we are finding out the outlier of the JETSCO, we have the provision to find out the outlier based on 2 or 3 standard deviation. Okay. It's based on the requirement. We can be able to change it out like 2 standard deviations, 3 standard deviations. Okay. After that, whatever the data points are, we can be able to call them an anomaly. Okay. So here we will be taking the standard deviation threshold as the threshold limit. Okay. So, let's take the threshold limit as 2. Okay. And then the mean means 2 standard deviation. And the mean is, we will be finding out the mean of data. And then for the standard deviation, we can be able to do np.std of the data. Alright. So these are the things we want. Okay, so let's check them out one by one. The mean is 25.52. Similarly, the standard deviation is 35.64. All right. Now, let's create some sort of analogy based on which it will go ahead and find out the outliers for us. Okay, so for I in data Z score I minus mean divided by the standard deviation. Once you do that, then if we will make it as absolute of Z score is greater than the threshold limit, then we will append that value into the outliers list. Alright, so once we do that, the outliers are being listed out in the outliers list. As you can be able to see, the outliers are 100, 120 and 130. Okay, so these are the three outliers that we have. And by the looks of it, the outliers are also the same, 100, 120 and 130. Okay. Now let's discuss one more method called as box plot. Using box plot also we can be able to detect the anomaly or outlier. So for that we will be importing seaborn. Import seaborn as SNS. Once it gets imported, SNS.boxplot. Okay. SNS dot box plot. What is the box plot we want? The data. Once we create the box plot, we can be able to see that this is the box or the boundary inside which all the data points are lying. And these three data points are moving away. Okay, which are the nothing but the data points as 100, 120 and 130, as you can be able to see. And rest all are inside this simple box. Okay, so this is how we can be able to decide the outlier and detect the outlier using the box plot also. So there are some other methods of detecting and removing the outliers also, which we will be discussing whenever we will be having any kind of data, any kind of problem statement, whenever we have real life problems, when we will be solving them out. Then if needed, then we will be creating some sort of other anomaly detection techniques also. Until then, stay tuned and enjoy machine learning. Thank you so much.